Hello everyone, and welcome to another one of my Warhammer 40k lore videos. Since I wanted to wrap up Imperial Navy ship classes, before I moved on to battleships, I remembered I omitted one of the most well-known and widespread escort-type vessels in the whole of the Imperium. So, today's episode will be dedicated to this fine vessel, aka the Sword-class Frigate, as well as a lesser-known escort ship, the Claymore-class Corvette. So without further ado, let us learn more about these, shall we? Escort-class ships are dedicated to support heavier warships during patrols, cruises, and engagements, protecting the larger and often much slower and more ponderous void ships' vulnerable flanks from attacks of opportunity. It is exceptionally rare to see an Imperial battleship or cruiser without at least two, if not more, Sword-class frigates by its side. The Sword-class is a very old design, which has been in service since the earliest days of the Imperium. A staple class upon which many other variants of Imperial escorts have been all based, its components have been tried, tested, refined, and if necessary, redesigned over innumerable engagements, resulting in a surprisingly efficient warship. As an escort, the Sword-class frigate is expected to come under fire, and was designed with this in mind. Its bulkheads are thicker than would be expected, and the beams and supports which hold the warship together have redundant copies that will take the load if the primary beam or support fails. Its banks of void shields are also strong and sturdy, designed to offer maximum protection for a void ship of its tonnage. Due to this, the Sword-class frigate can take more punishment than would be expected for a ship of its diminutive size. Its laser-based weapon batteries provide equivalent firepower to those of the less reliable plasma-based alternative. Those batteries are able to fire both sides or forward at full strength. The class's plasma engines are powerful, yet simple enough to be maintained by a freshly ordained tech priest, and are regardless as reliable even under extreme duress or after the warship has suffered heavy damage. The Sword-class frigate does suffer from one drawback. While potent, its laser-based weapon batteries are by Void Warfare standards quite short-ranged, and a Sword-class frigate captain must always be wary of biting off more than he can chew. While its strong void shields and superior structural integrity allows a Sword-class frigate to go head-to-head with even an Iconoclast-class destroyer and emerge battered but victorious, its lack of long-range armament can prove detrimental in larger engagements if it finds itself without support from the heavier warships. This flaw was perfectly illustrated during the Battle of Bellatis, when the duo of Sword-class frigates Pegasus and Achilles came under surprise attack from the Murder-class cruiser Charybdis and its escorting Infidel-class raiders. Caught too far away from the cruiser they escorted to withdraw back to it in time, both ships bravely decided to bring the battle to the foe rather than flee. But the Pegasus was destroyed by a concentrated torpedo volley from the Infidels before it could even get into firing range. The Achilles fared slightly better, crippling one of the Infidels before powering onward toward the Charybdis, but was finally obliterated by its much larger opponent's broadside before being able to maneuver itself into firing range. Sword-class frigates are so well-liked and efficient that even many Space Marine chapter fleets include them in support of their battle barges and cruisers, whenever they can. Because of their excellent performance, swords are also valued by rogue traders, who usually convert them to contain more cargo space to meet their merchant needs. Pirate fleets have also been known to operate captured Sword-class frigates. Some notable Sword-class frigates and squadrons of frigates include the Achilles. The Achilles fought during the Gothic War. It participated in the Battle of Helia IV and the evacuation of the planet Bellatis. During that battle, the Achilles and its sister ship, the Pegasus, were ambushed and destroyed by the Murder-class cruiser Charybdis and its escorts of Infidel raiders. His Hammer. The sword-class frigate, his Hammer, is part of the escort squadrons of Battlefleet Corribra, which protects Imperial worlds in this sector from alien attack and invasion. They are a part of the 50 warships, which have the duty to patrol and guard the Corribra sector. No small task for so few ships. The Mariatus. Commanded by Captain Payne, the Mariatus was the lead ship of a squadron of three sword-class frigates which took part in the defense of Tarsis Ultra from the encroaching Tyranid High Fleet Leviathan. The Triumph of Juno. The Triumph of Juno patrols the rimward fringes of the Styges Cluster subsector, and it has seen its fair share of combat with Eldar pirates and Orc raiders. Its armsmen are renowned through Battlefleet Ascalon for their skills at repelling boarders, and the ship even carries a small complement of attack boats for offensive assault. The Absolution Squadron. Almost freshly commissioned at the docks of Hydrafer, Absolution Squadron was initially headed for the Cadian Gate as part of the naval reinforcement during the 13th Black Crusade, but was later diverted to the Trail of Saint Evisser. There, it participated in the protection of the Trail's capital world of Volcanis Ultor, the squadron's leading vessel, the Absolution Beta, bravely sacrificing itself to ensure the destruction of what it believed was a Chaos Strike cruiser. However, the ship's true identity was the Rubicon, a vessel bound in service to the Grey Knights, and on a vital mission to save the Trail from its impending doom. The Red Squadron. The 202nd Red Squadron was a sword frigate squadron that consisted of four sword-class frigates that fought in Battlefleet Gothic during the Gothic War. The Blue Squadron and Omega Squadron were both sword frigate squadrons which fought in Battlefleet Gothic during the Gothic War. The Errant Squadron. This was a frigate squadron that fought in the Taros campaign against the Tau Empire. It was eventually wiped out trying to defend an Imperial troop convoy from the Tau cruiser Io Tar. The Invictus Squadron. This was yet another sword-class formation that fought in the Taros campaign against the Tau. It was reassigned to perform convoy protection duty after the annihilation of the previous convoy and its entirety of escorts by a Tau cruiser. The Triumph Squadron is a sword frigate squadron which served in the Imperial Navy Task Force called Battlefleet Coronas, undertaking countless patrol and interdiction duties in the Coronas Expanse, hunting pirates, enforcing blockades, and protecting Imperial convoys. There are a dozen sword-class frigates in Triumph Squadron, and they are often spread across Battlefleet Coronas's area of operations. The dimensions for the sword-class frigate are a length of approximately 1.6 kilometers, a mass of approximately 6 megatons, a crew of approximately 26,000, and a maximum sustainable acceleration of 4.5 gravities. The Claymore-class Corvette. Corvettes are specialist escort craft, usually slightly smaller and less powerful than real frigates, but slower and more heavily armored than raiders. Typically constructed rapidly in times of war, corvettes utilize single components and rugged designs. Their normal mission profile is to escort vulnerable transports, protecting them against light raiders, thus freeing more valuable frigates to accompany battleships and cruisers. Corvettes are unpopular with Imperial Navy officers. Most Imperial battlefleets tend to have many parochial and conservative tendencies, and receiving orders to nursemaid civilian vessels in a newly constructed and untested warship is seen as demeaning, or even a calculated insult. Despite this, the corvettes have upheld the traditions of the Imperial Navy for thousands of years, hurling themselves in the path of more powerful and dangerous vessels, their actions often saving millions of lives. More than 50 of these stopgap vessels were constructed during the Angevin Crusade to cover losses in the sword-class frigate squadrons, churned out by the Adeptus Mechanicus mobile shipyards and small civilian concerns orbiting stronghold worlds like Xenophia. few of these ships currently serve in Battlefleet Calixus. They were rewarded for their bravery by almost immediately being relegated to reserve fleets or sold to opportunistic rogue traders. The latter appreciate them for what they are: cheap when compared to other warships, easily maintained, and relatively common. The dimensions for the Claymore are approximately 1.4 kilometers in length, with a mass of approximately 5.9 megatons, a crew of approximately 21,000, and a maximum sustainable acceleration of 4.6 gravities. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you on the ubiquitous Sword-class frigate and the underappreciated Claymore Corvette. With this video, like I mentioned in the beginning, we are gonna be finished for the time being with ship classes like destroyers, frigates, and cruisers. I do realize there's more of these kinds of ships if you take into account Xenos vessels, traitor vessels, or even Space Marine vessels, but even though I haven't yet decided how I'll integrate those in my series, I will undoubtedly get to do them in due time. Battleships are next, but I will take a short break from ship videos before getting into those, as I feel I've been making kind of a lot of them lately. If you have any thoughts or questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video or found it informative, please consider clicking the like button and subscribing. And if you'd like to show your support and help my channel, please go check my Patreon page. The link is in the video description. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you an awesome day. The Emperor protects.